Mujebale, welcome to Be Encouraged, a series of devotions stemming from personal Bible reading over the years. Today we're looking at a verse most quoted in prayer, 1 John 4:18. Perfect love casts out all fear. The Bible says that love is of God and God is love. In other words, love is a fundamental characteristic of who God is. Everything God does is impelled and influenced by His love. And there's a distinct word for the type of love that God displays. In the Greek, this word is agape, and it refers to a benevolent, charitable love that seeks the best of the loved one. 1 John 4:18 says, "Perfect love casts out fear." The whole verse says that there is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear has to do with punishment, and the one who fears is not made perfect in love. The context here is important. Verse 17 says, "This is how love is made complete among us, so that we will have confidence on the day of judgment." COVID, kidding, subscribe. The fear that perfect love casts out is the fear of judgment. We know that the judgment day is coming, but those who are in Christ know the love of God, which drives away fear of condemnation. Dismissal of the fear of judgment is one of the main functions of God's love. The person without Christ is under judgment and has plenty to fear. But once a person is in Christ, the fear of judgment is gone. He's reconciled to God, and there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Part of understanding the love of God is knowing that God's judgment fell on Jesus at the cross so that we can be spared. The Lord has laid on Him the iniquity of us all. Jesus' sacrifice propitiated, which means appeased, God's justice and won His good favor. I mean, Jesus spoke often of His mission. God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through Him. The only person who must fear judgment is the one who rejects Jesus Christ. I mean, whoever does not believe stands condemned already because they have not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. That's verse 18. The Bible says that nothing can separate the believer from the love of God in Christ. God's love does not wax and wane. It's not fickle or emotional sensation. God's love for sinners is why Christ died on the cross. And God's love for those who trust in Christ is why He holds their hand. And He says that He will never let them go. That divine love should take away our fear. Do not be afraid to flock, for your Father has pleased to give you the kingdom. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and love and of sound mind. A spiritual fearfulness and timidity does not come from God. Sometimes this spirit of fear overcomes us, and to overcome it, we need to trust in and love God more completely. If as a child of God, we still fear God's punishment, we have not yet reached the point of maturity in love. And to help us be complete in love, God has literally sprinkled encouragement against fear throughout the Bible. My hope is that you trust this God who loves so graciously, so that you may be able to be like the psalmist who says, "Let all who take refuge in you be glad. Let them sing for joy and spread your protection over them, that those who love your name may rejoice in you." Be encouraged. I love you. Last line. And God's love for those who Christ, who try. God's love does not wax and wane. It's not fickle or emotional sensation. God's love for sinners is why Christ died on the cross.